Emma Donovan and the Putbacks.
And I can't feel the
it was here in the sweet dawn.
my love to everybody that's at home tonight. Wrapped up. Laying up with friends, maybe a couple of friends around. Just want to send all our love and say hello. Shout outs now and just pay my respects to local traditional mob here and thank Auntie for her welcome tonight, and also Benny and Alex for their beautiful sets. So nice to hear you mob play, and just for anybody that's tuning in, I know that my dad and my mama are tuned in tonight and they're from WA, so just sending all the love out there to Dad and the family, and hope that everybody, just enjoys it. I'm gonna play some songs from our album Dawn. Really lucky to be here and be a part of tonight, so thank you. Darling, I've been waiting all this time. Been showing you my strength and what it can be a good woman. But lately it's made no sense. Lately it's made no sense. Honey, you're my main man, but you need to show that I can rely on you to care and grow. So take me to the top, baby, where I need to be. Take me to the top, baby, baby, please. I ain't gonna be your mother. I ain't gonna be your sister too. I wanna be your lover. I need to be your lover, 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 love. Yeah.
Thank you.
on living this way. Yeah. Soon I'm gonna be the one you hate. So pack your things if you need to go. Pack your things if you already know that I'm gonna be your mother. Said I ain't gonna be your sister too. Beautiful song by our lovely Annie Ruby Hunter. The song's called Yari and Michi.
Yananani Yari and Michi. Yananani Yari and Michi.
Yeah.
napia nangiti. Yaria mititi.
I have to say something because it's just, it's been a while since we had a little play, and being this close on stage and having a little sing. So we've got a couple of more tunes and we just want to, look, I'd just personally like to thank everybody that's here in this small studio for being here and everybody, of course, at home. But yeah, just the delivered mob for making this possible. I got a little bit sooky there at the start of just being home and not having any gigs, and it's been really nice to be here and to be with you all. So I hope you enjoy these next couple of tunes and take care of your mob out there. And we'll see you all really soon. This next song is a tune called Black Woman, and it's off of our first album, Dawn. Big love to everyone.
But keep on giving till you just can't hear. No more, no more, no more.
we're going to finish up with this beautiful tune. It's a song that's on our record, Dawn. Song called Over, Under and Away. Thank you for listening out there. See us all soon. Things I don't understand about how I rise and how I see my life. But if I don't get up now every day and sing and shout and we talk up loud, then I'll be the fool who's always left it crying. And in my mind I know, no, I can't survive. But I can rush and worry about getting anywhere on time, anywhere on time. Over, under, away, whatever it takes, baby, I'll wait. Over, under, away, whatever it takes, baby, I'll wait. Said I'll wait. Place to call our home. You'll be here soon, I know. But I can't worry about getting anywhere on time, anywhere on time. No, I can't rush or get anywhere on time, anywhere on time. I know I can't. Hey, thank you so much.
Woo! Woo!
I'm gonna
Emma
send,
Donovan
this.
And the Putbacks. As expected, blew my mind, but shattered my skull in a few different ways I didn't quite expect that I'm still recovering from. How about that? As Lisa said on YouTube, another local band for me to support. I love how I'm learning so many bands I didn't know for delivered live rather than following the same ones all the time. Hey, we've got great news. Thanks to all of your lavish emojis, we've got an encore. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to welcome back Emma Donovan and the Putbacks for an encore. Thanks, guys.
Hey, I just want to give a big shout out to all my family, the Donovan family. Been working really close, singing my grandfather's songs in the last couple of months. So, I want to finish with a family little treasure called The Promised Land. When my journey from life has ended in a land not far away, where the sun shines down so brightly and the skies they're never gray, the clover fields are blooming and the beach has golden sand. That's the place we'll meet someday, and it's called the Promised Land. In the Promised Land, that's where I'll be, with you there by my side, the angels singing softly, acting as our guide. We'll stroll where it's so peaceful, going hand in hand, and we know we are at home. Mountain peaks are the highest and the clear water flows. The valleys are so beautiful where the wild red roses grow, and the ridges they're covered in flowers, and the sea is something bread. That's the place we're gonna meet one day, and it's called the Promised Land. In the Promised Land, that's where I'll be, with you there by my side, the angels singing softly, acting as our guide. We'll stroll where it's so peaceful, going hand
hand in hand, and we know we are at home here in the promised land. That's the place said we gonna meet someday, and it's called the promised land.
Yes, Emma Donovan and the Putbacks. How good does it feel to see live music streamed at you? No pre-records here. All the music is coming at you as it happens. It's great. I hope you've enjoyed Delivered Live here tonight. I'd like to announce, I've been talking about the inadequacy of my hair all evening, and you've been sharing with me your unkempt isolation do's. I have the proud duty to announce that the winner of the Sony outdoor sound system with rechargeable batteries and cup holders, for God's sake, who has cup holders in their stereo? I tell you, you do. Toby Arnott from Torquay. Be the envy of your next picnic. Absolutely smash that picnic next to you with your band of choice, perhaps your new Emma and the Putbacks record. You can go to deliveredlive.com.au and find direct links to every single artist's merch page up there. A very close second goes to Georgie, who put a kind of a brutalist profile pic on her Facebook page and told us that she shaved off her hair in isolation because it was annoying her. And we like the pick. You're getting a Delivered Live merch pack too. I was overwhelmed with the number of clapping emojis, star emojis, high praise emojis for the one and only Emma Donovan. Would you mind coming in and having a chat? How good? Yeah, have a seat. Oh, have a seat. How do you feel?
I feel like a hot toddy or something, because I feel like I lost my voice a little bit.
Oh, the husk is where it's at, though.
I know. And you know, all I've been doing is yelling around at my little girls. Like, you know, I've just been home with my babies and I haven't really been singing much.
Do you think, look, you couldn't tell at all. You know, I think you were hitting those notes until the very, very end. Thank you so much for doing the encore too. I was about to play you out and there was this, everyone's constant, she's doing it. There's an encore, happening. Cool. Everything like YouTube was coming out at me 3D. Nice. So I'm very glad you played again. How have you been spent? You mentioned, are you spending your isolation with your family? What's a day in the life
Just me and my little girls. I've got two little ones. One's four and one's going to be two in July. So, yeah, they're just bossing me around.
That'd keep you busy.
Just bossing me around. I just took... So my oldest one went back to school for one day on the Tuesday. But, yeah, no, we've just been home together. And it's good because, you know, I'm always chucking them around the family for gigs.
Yeah, right.
You know, like so they stay with all the aunties and the nens and pops, so...
I'm finding with my own six-year-old daughter, she actually wants to keep it this way. You know, she's sort of into the being surrounded by her family and into the four walls. Is there any part of this life that you actually want to keep once this is over?
Look, you know, it's funny. Like I said, like I'm away all the time doing gigs, and so I got this little thing where, you know, my baby stay with family, and so like my little one, she's had so much to do with hardly me, just like Nan and Pop and the aunties and that. So I think I want to keep her. You know, like I just want to. I don't want her to go back to school.
You
know,
she's a bubba. Your kids.
she's a bubba. What have I done? You know. I haven't had much time with the second one. I didn't have much time with the big one. Oh, she went everywhere with me. Mm. But, you know, she's bigger. But yeah.
Did you have to cancel a bunch of stuff when this virus hit?
I was ready to do a lot of stuff with Uncle Arch, actually.
Right.
Yeah. He asked me to be a part of he's, you know, like the memoir, the album that he had for that, Tell Me Why.
Archie Roach is actually part of the Recharge Festival tomorrow.
Tomorrow night,
you guys are ships in the night. Yeah. What a shame.
Yeah, I should just stay another night.
Just hang.
and come and do my gigs that
just
I was meant to do with him.
At a safe social distance, but crash the hell out of it.
Yeah, yeah. But no, thank you. Thanks for having us. Like, tonight we probably played one new album from the record that's got a connection to Uncle Arch, and that was Yarian Michi, which is Annie Ruby's tune. Mm-hmm. So, the Putbacks and I are ready to finally release another album at the end of the year.
Ruby Heads, Arch is playing a lot of Charcoal Lane tomorrow.
Oh, nice.
And I know Ruby was so integral in the building of that record too. We've got some questions on YouTube for you, if you're willing to face the internet. Linda is wondering what it was like to work with Mavis. She first saw you at the Maya Music Bowl with Mavis Staples.
So not the one that we just recently did at the zoo?
Oh, it could be. I'm not sure.
That was a while back.
Linda?
Like our last gig before this gig now.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Oh, I got you. What was it like working with Mavis?
I didn't work with her. I went out and opened up the afternoon for her.
But
I didn't really kind of see
same bill.
I was busting my I was busting myself to just, you know, sneak in a little cuddle or something. But she's like, you know, by the time I kind of, because I went out the front to see her perform, and I, you know, by the time I kind of ran around the back and she'd finished her set, she was away and gone in her little car.
You didn't sort of try and bribe some security guards or try and get in there?
I was lucky that I went the next day down to WOMAD, so I did the Mavis Staples Zoo support. Mm. And then I went and supported my friend Delene Briscoe and some other mob down at WOMAD, and she was doing a gig there, and then I snuck around there.
Yes.
And she was on the little cart, you know, she couldn't get away fast enough. So
what did you do to her?
Because the little buggies out there
in the
backstage for that WOMAD. But I'd been yarning to the backing singers. And she'd seen us sing a couple of times with Uncle Archie, actually. When they were backing Sharon Jones. Years ago, when Uncle Arch supported Sharon's gig at Woodford.
We were part
of Uncle Archie's choir.
Wow.
So, yeah, and it was nice to make that connection again with her backing singer, Sandra Williams, who's in a beautiful duet with Sean and Star.
Yeah, yeah, wow.
It's one of my favourite albums.
Oh, we're talking some incredible musicians here. All hanging around the zoo.
Yeah, hanging around the zoo, talking about animals at the zoo.
There you go.
It was all good.
Andy's wondering, how do you decide on a set list for a gig like this in particular?
Is that Mick's wife, Andy? Is she making a joke of us?
I don't know. No, Andy's been hanging and watching all the bands, but yeah, you never know. But is there anything about maybe selecting songs for a gig like this where you know there's not going to be an audience, you know, compared to a normal gig?
It was easy tonight because we just want to, we haven't had a play for ages. We're just looking. Actually, we wanted to play more of the album, of the new album, but because it hasn't been released yet, we just thought we'd hold back on a couple.
So what are your plans? How has this pandemic affected the rollout of your new stuff?
Well, it's kind of taken a little bit of time to do anyway, but it's kind of given us space or more time to just iron out, like, maybe, you know, some of the legal things around it, like, making sure that we get the right, you know, credits and stuff like, revisiting other contracts and things from...
Yeah, a lot of people are saying...
Like, just time to iron out other stuff
just
that needed to happen, I guess. I don't know.
Extra sort of diligence time. A lot of people are saying that maybe they're not producing anymore, but they're maybe spending more time on what they're doing. It's giving them the opportunity to care more and actually spend more time on things.
Just get ready to, you know, when we do release new music, that everything else around it is all, happy.
People also seem to be doing that, spending more time on their creative projects and making homemade pasta for the first time. Have you been experimenting with any new music or perhaps any cooking for the first time?
I was just telling the Putbacks, you know, I've had a bit, I've been writing a little bit more, but drinking and writing at the same time, I don't know if that's
You got to self-medicate. Been all right. When you're hosting from a bar that looks like this, thank you, Young Henry's and High Country Wines. You know, if people want to spot the difference each and every episode, a few things disappear every week. I hear, but yeah. Alcohol and rock and roll are, you know, a heady mix.
Just trying to still keep writing, and when I got that bit of time, especially when the girls are asleep, always try and write anyway.
Squeeze in time in between the quiet time, quiet time with the kids. Linda wants to know, is it hard singing emotional songs without an audience there to give you feedback?
Oh, no. I think there was one song there, I think because we haven't sang it for such a long time, Over, Under, and Away, I got a little bit sooky.
Oh, like that I did too.
I was having a...
Beautiful.
Yeah, I don't know, maybe... Like that song's really about time. I wrote that song when I was waiting for a long time for someone to come back or to come home. And I don't know, I kind of just went there with the whole, it's this uncertainty of, you know, when things are going to get lifted or, you know, things will kind of go back a little bit normal. So I don't know, maybe I was getting a little bit emotional about it.
When there's less people just in the now. Room and less of a crowd in your face, maybe there's more time to go inward on that stage, maybe.
Mm. Yeah.
What's next for you? What are your plans for the coming months while hopefully there's a light at the end of the tunnel? What's Emma Donovan up to?
Well, we got to try and release something, at the end of the year. We're all set to go. We just finished getting a lot of our album complete now. So, just looking forward to the end product, getting some more artwork, I guess, done, finishing all that up. But, yeah, just putting something out there finally. It's been a long time since I released anything with the Putbacks. Yeah, it's been a long couple of years.
I'm excited about it. And just to finish off, your inspirations are so incredibly classic and amazing soul music, I know. Is there anything, maybe a record that you'd like to give us a little tip on to help people through their isolation? Is there some music that's been your go-to to survive?
I've been listening to everything. But I did have a little sing to myself a couple of weeks ago because I'm up in Sydney and the Putbacks are down this way. And I think it was at the start of the pandemic when, you know, people were really locked in and we were, you know, no one was moving. But I had a little sing of a Bob Marley and a Wailers song called High Tide, Low Tide. I don't know if you know that one, but...
Yeah. It's a classic.
It's, had a sing of it and...
Put it on at home. And thanks once again to Emma Donovan and the Putbacks. A round of applause. Thank you so much, Emma.